Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Wednesday, February 2nd. Enjoy another day of warmer weather. We're going to see some more snow melting today, but definite changes are on the way. Our chief meteorologist, Dan Zero, says rain and ice and snow are all in the weather mix as we approach the weekend. We have full details on air, online at nj1015.com and on our free mobile app. The CDC data tracker still lists community transmission as high in every one of New Jersey's 21 counties, but the state's COVID metrics continue to fall, or at least stabilize at a relatively lower level. The number of new infections continues to drop. Just 2,400 new positive tests logged statewide on Tuesday. The rate of transmission remains at 0.55. Slightly more people were admitted to the hospital than discharged, but the total number of occupied beds remains below 3,000. Even as the pandemic continues, should it really be considered endemic at this point? Is COVID going to be with us pretty much forever, circling the globe? A leading infectious disease specialist in New Jersey says yes. That from Dr. Stanley H. Weiss, an epidemiologist at Rutgers, but he says it doesn't mean that COVID is no longer a threat, even if it's going to be with us for the long term, because in many people, it still can cause severe illness, hospitalization, and in rarer cases, death. Pfizer is now asking state drug regulators and federal regulators to approve their vaccine for kids as young as 6 months. The FDA is rushing approval, hoping to have the microdose shots available for kids under the age of 5 as early as March. Lawmakers could have limited Governor Phil Murphy's pandemic powers if they would have just given him what he wanted, that 45-day extension of his pandemic powers that were preserved back in June when the public health emergency was first eliminated, would have capped some of what Murphy was able to do, particularly the strict new vaccine mandates for healthcare workers, corrections officers, or anyone working in congregate settings. Murphy would not have been allowed to go beyond CDC recommendations, which do not include booster shots. I write more about that and its impact at nj1015.com this morning. New details this morning about the intimidation and harassment allegedly at the hands of a Mount Laurel man targeting his neighbors. You may remember Edward Matthews for his racist tirade caught on video last summer that sparked protests at his home. A new indictment alleges that he left a threatening note and smeared feces on a neighbor's car. A search of his home also found a slingshot and ball bearings believed to have been used to shoot at cars. Matthews has been in the Burlington County lockup since his arrest last July. In Patterson, a garbage man is charged with assaulting a restaurant worker after he had asked for a free beer and the restaurant worker refused. Originally, the worker had offered the entire garbage crew water, but one of the men wanted a beer instead. Well, now the restaurant worker who is injured is suing not only the garbage hauling company, but the city itself, saying they didn't properly vet their workers and that the garbage man who attacked him had a history of violence and shouldn't have passed a background check. A Superior Court judge has denied a bid by former Senate President Steve Sweeney to remain a member of the commission who's redrawing legislative boundaries in New Jersey. Sweeney did not have to lose his spot on the Apportionment Commission as a consequence of losing re-election, but Democratic Party State Chair Leroy Jones removed him last week, and the judge said he had every right to do that. It is hoped that that indoor track bubble in Toms River will be open again in a matter of days after suffering damage during last week's storms. Crews have been working to repair the damage from the deflated bubble. Almost every wintertime indoor track event is held at that site. The next is the state sectionals, February 11th. If all goes well, the track will be ready before then. State police in New Jersey need your help identifying and capturing a road rage suspect. They've released some video and still shots of the vehicle that they're looking for. The man in this vehicle is accused of shooting a fellow motorist to death on Route 76 in Camden County. Whatever beef the two drivers had apparently began in Philadelphia the night of January 24th. It continued across the Walt Whitman Bridge. Shots were fired. The driver of a black Mercedes found dead. The other driver got away. If you're looking for a romantic Valentine's Day getaway, that's not too far away from home. Our Steve Trevelise says he has found one of New Jersey's most romantic hotels. He tells you all about it at an article at NJ1015.com. And just a reminder, join me tomorrow night at 7 as I kick off our new Access New Jersey series. I'll be joined by Ken Kamen from Mercadian Asset Management for a special Facebook Live event. If you've been watching your 401k or retirement funds dwindle in the new year, we're going to help you ask the right questions and make the right decisions about your financial future. We'll be taking your questions in the live chat. That's Facebook Live tomorrow night at 7. It's part of the New Jersey 101.5 Access New Jersey series, and participation is free. If you have something to say about our top stories, leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's first news for this Wednesday, February 2nd. Have a great day.